In the previous video, we have seen the concept of virtual memory, and virtual memory is implemented by using demand paging. Demand paging system is similar to paging system with swapping. In demand paging, pages are only loaded when they are in demand and not in advance they are executed. When we want to execute a process, we swap it into the memory. Rather than swapping the entire process into memory, we use lazy swapper. A lazy swapper never swaps a page into the memory unless the page will be needed. With this scheme, we need to implement with the hardware support. For hardware support, we implement two bits here, valid and invalid bit. When the bit is set to valid, the associated page is in the memory, and when bit is set to invalid, the associated page is on the disk. So you here in this diagram, you can easily see that A, C and F, these blocks are in the physical memory. That's why the corresponding blocks are valid in the page table. A, C, F. A, C, F, its position are 4, 6 and 9. So frame number 4, 6 and 9 are valid because these frames or corresponding blocks are available in the physical memory. On the contrary, other blocks are invalid blocks, for example 5, 7, 8, 10, 11. These blocks are not available in the physical memory. That's why its corresponding bits are invalid. If the process tries to access a page that was not brought into memory, then page fault occurs. When the page is not available in the frame, then page fault occurs. Hardware for handling this page fault is given below. So this is the diagram which indicates how the page fault or trapping of page fault will occur. So these are the steps. We check an internal table for this process to determine whether the reference was valid or invalid memory access. If the reference was invalid, we terminate the process. If it was valid but we have not yet brought page in it, so there are 1 to 6 steps, or there are 1 to 6 steps here for loading that page into the memory or into the frame. So this is the scenario. Second, we find the frame. Second step is we find the frame. We schedule the disk operation to read the desired page into the newly allocated frame. When disk read is complete, we modify the internal table kept with the process and page table to indicate that the page is now in the memory. We restart the instruction that was interrupted by the trap. This process can now access the page as though it had always been in the memory. So this is how your very first stage is load M to page table. So page will be loaded into page table. Then if the reference is valid or invalid, as per the valid or invalid bit, it gets trapped into the it will trap by the operating system. Then the page is on the backing store. Then in backing store, it is stored here in the backing store. Then page is brought in the physical memory. After physical memory, the page table get reset, and after resetting the page table, it will load it into the memory. So this is how actually in the background these things happen, but the user can think that it has already in the memory, but the page is not already in the memory. It has to come from backing store, then from physical memory to page table, and from page table to at our side. Now for page replacement or page swapping algorithm, we have three algorithms for page replacement. FIFO, that is first in first out page replacement algorithm, optimal page replacement algorithm, and least recently used page replacement algorithms. These three algorithms are used for replacing the pages or swapping the pages from the memory to frame.